days are over, and at long last the big day has dawned. Well, it's 9 o'clock in the morning, Saturday the 22nd of January 1983, an historic day in the history of Abergavenny Rugby Football Club. Already supporters have started to congregate from all parts of the town to fill the 15 coaches who have been booked to transport the vast army of support down west, hoping that Abergavenny can succeed where the might of New Zealand have gone and failed. Was on a dark and dismal day when telephone call came. Mike Aylett on the phone to say, "Can you film the game? We've drawn Llanelli in the cup. Off to the land of song. This game must all be put on film. A gift from Alan Long." So here we are at Bailey Park. The team is set to go. Supporters in their droves have left to see the Stradey show. Those weeks of training are behind. You lads are at your best. Let's see if this Llanelli team can put you to the test. If Tony Mack has done his job, then no team should you fear. A victory at Stradey Park will make supporters cheer. And then Max Boyce would have to write a sequel, 293. Just imagine names in lights like Pontypool's front three. Before this match, you have become the heroes of this town. So off you go to Sospenbach and try and bring them down. But if you don't, one thing is sure, this match has made us one. When rugby team and town unite to see a job well done. So lads, the rest is up to you, as you journey way down west, With pride we send you on your way. We know you'll do your best. Let's hope result is what you want. If not, don't despair. Enjoy your day and then relax and think, yes, we were there.
Chicken, don't you? Come on, Jeff, you can see it.
Jeff,
put
the paper
there. It's
yeah.
The wrong paper, it should be the telegraph.
It should be the Times.
Come around the back room, you can zoom in on it then.
Oh, Jeff's in management, you can see that, can't you?
Yeah. Come on, Pete, get over there, buddy.
Spot on the table.
Get over there, Pete.
Terry Griffiths.
No word there.
Come on, girl. Right, boys. Let's think about it now. It's a marvellous day for us, as we all know. We've got 15 coaches down here today, probably 1,200 supporters down here with us. It's a game for Abergavenny, it's a game for the town, and most of all, it's a game for the club. We've waited 107 years for this one, and this afternoon, we're going to show the Llanelli that we are by no means the minnows in the backwoods of a market town that they can't even pronounce on the television. It's our game today, not their game. It's a game we've waited, as I say, a long, long time for. We've now got the icing on the cake. We've got a big draw. Everyone this afternoon is going to be 100% for Aberavenny. The crowd's going to be behind us, that's a certainty. We've never seen so many buses. So this afternoon, all I'm asking is 200% of every player on the field. There's six poor buggers on that bench on the side who are not going to get a crack at it unless someone gets injured. But let's think about them on the side as well. Plus the other 30 we've left behind or are in the stand watching us. They're all part of the club. We've got a tremendous club win at the moment. Last 5 or 6 seasons, we've had more success in the clubs than the last 107 years. As I say, this is the icing on the cake for us today. So let's get on that park. We don't give a bugger for reputations. All we know, Mars, is a bloody side. They've got 15 pairs of legs, 15 bloody pairs of arms. We lit bloody 10 bags of you-know-what of them this afternoon, and we're going to go right in there every time. We know our style of rugby. We like to throw the ball around, they like to throw it round. We've got a lovely day for it, so let's go at them. We're not going to hang back and let them come at us, because they'll do it all bloody day. Our rugby is going at them. If we haven't got the ball, we're going at them and put them under so much pressure that they're going to make mistakes. And once they make the mistakes, we're in there to pick everything up. Scrummaging's got to be spot on. We can scrimmage this side this afternoon, hopefully. That's where we're going to put a bit of a dent in there, bloody pride. Rucking and mauling. If you don't like the rucking, let's get there. Let's suck them in. Let's stop that back row flying all around the field and causing havoc with us. And stop the ball getting out there to Bernard Thomas and the rest of them. Lineouts, we know we're going to be up against it. Let's do what we can. What ball they get isn't going to be worth having. We've got nothing to lose this afternoon. It's all there for us. Let's just go out there, play our style of rugby, and as I say, let's put Abergavenny on the map. Once and for all.
Well, here we are at the Stradey Hotel, Llanelli, standing on the steps here with the committee of Abergavenny Rugby Club. On my left-hand side, I have their chairman, Mr. Mike Hylett. And Mike, well, the day has arrived. 6 weeks ago, you found out that you were drawn against Llanelli. It's all of your committee's hands now. It's up to the players. How do you think the game will go today?
I think it'll be a good, hard game. I think the boys on the day will do themselves justice. Cup football, anything can happen, and hopefully we'll come away with a good result.
Well, it can only augur well for the club. You're also, I believe, in the later stages of the Ben Francis Cup, having beaten Garndiffith in the last round.
Yeah, we play Risker at the end of the month. That is the quarter-final stage. Everything looks good. We have a tremendous spirit in the club at the present moment, and apart from our first team, our second team and third team, all following up with good results.
Wonderful. Let's hope the boys do themselves justice today out there against Llanelli, and hope that they'll come back with a good result. An hour and a quarter to go before the kick-off down at Stradey. The Abergavenny side make their way onto the coach for the short journey down to the changing rooms. Paul Exton, Kevin Neal, the captain, Nigel Evans. The boys have had their team talk. They're all feeling confident of playing a good game of rugby today against this Llanelli 15. As the bus starts up and the players, Mark Lloyd fighting his way onto the bus, followed by Kevin Neal. The committee all looking a little bit apprehensive, but happy with the fact that they are coming here today to play against probably the best rugby club side in the world. And as the last of the committee men make their way onto the bus, in 3.5 hours' time, we know the result. Whether Abergavenny has come here today to beat Llanelli or not will be found out later on today. Driver checking to make sure everyone's on. And off they go.
Paul Exton, fullback. Original member of the highly successful youth team of 1972, Paul went on to represent the British Polytechnics. On returning to Abergavenny, he gained representation for Monmouthshire County and Monmouthshire Rugby Union. Has played top-class football with Pontypool and Abertillery. David James, right wing. One of the senior members of the side, he has played in most positions in the backs, but in recent years has made the right wing berth his own. David holds the club's try-scoring record for Abergavenny, having established over 100 touchdowns in a distinguished career. John Gunter, centre. John has been a regular member of the team over recent years and has played a big part in its success. Not the biggest of centres around, but it is doubtful if there are many who tackle so hard and so effectively. Nigel Evans, centre. Nigel is serving his third term as club captain, another youth team product, a versatile player who is equally at home on the wing or centre, a strong, determined runner whose club loyalty has positively limited his chances of playing at a higher level. Kevin Neal, left wing. Kevin is in his first season of regular first team football. He has won his place against strong opposition. Yet another bonus from the club's effective youth policy, Kevin has the potential ability to go on to greater things. Gary Inge, outside half. Another newcomer to the senior side, direct from last season's youth team, Gary has had to work extremely hard to retain the number 10 jersey in the face of more experienced candidates. Show's ability to get around the field quickly and is one of the club's goal kickers. Jeff Gardner, scrum half. Former youth team captain, Ginty has been the key to much of the club's success over recent years. Generally recognised as one of the best scrum halves in Gwent, his attitude to every game is an example to teammates and opponents alike. Alan Jones, prop forward. Alan formed a formidable partnership with his present colleagues in the successful youth team of 1972. Since that time, he has been the most regular member of the first team, a conscientious trainer and outstanding clubman. Brian Clark, hooker. Another former youth team captain, he also led Abergavenny to victory in the Ben Francis Cup final. One of the most respected players in Gwent, a formidable opponent, Brian's skills are enhanced by club loyalty and dedication to his craft. Peter Rastell, prop forward. One of the most improved players in the team over recent seasons, he is from the same youth team as many of his colleagues. Peter's current form has attracted the attention of a number of other clubs. A powerful scrummager. Wayne Trumper, lock forward. This season's vice-captain, Wayne has celebrated his recent fatherhood by producing his best form for a number of years. Only 11 stone when playing youth rugby, Wayne has matured to a healthy 16 stone and is an essential part of the powerhouse, a good front-of-the-line jumper. Gareth Havard, lock forward. Another new member to the team, he has made the most of his early opportunities. In his first real season, he has shown a willingness to learn, and using his 6 foot plus and 16 stone to good effect, again, he has progressed from the youth team. Jeff Williams, flanker. Jeff has settled well into his position as flanker. He has worked hard at improving his game and is already gaining a reputation for his deadly tackling and speed around the field. Mike Williams, number 8. Mike has every reason to be delighted with his form this season. His strong, aggressive style has earned the admiration of club supporters as well as teammates. His work rate and energy have been the platform of his personal success. Terry Richards, back row. Captain Monmouthshire Rugby Union during the league championship team in season 1979-80, and this season was originally appointed Quinn's captain. Injuries, however, necessitated a quick return to first team duty, and his form has made it impossible to leave him out, a totally committed clubman. Mostyn Richards. Brother of Terry, he joined the club last season after yeoman service with Ebbw Vale and Pontypool. His motivating influence has been invaluable, having represented Monmouthshire County and East Wales against the Argentinian Pumas. Hugh Jenkins, scrum half. Hugh joined the club earlier this season from Bridgend Sports. A regular member of the Quinns team, his standard of play would ensure first-team football in many clubs. Whilst at Chester College, he was included in the English Colleges squad. Tony McPherson. As well as providing front row cover for the first team due to injuries, Tony is also the official club coach. Yet another youth product, his uncompromising style has brought representative honours with the British Colleges team whilst at Cardiff Training College. A senior member, he is still capable of playing at the highest level. Andrew Goldsworthy, prop or hooker. Andrew is rapidly making his name in serious rugby, a robust front row forward who impresses with his speed about the field. The club hope to use his services for many years to come. Keith Knight, lock forward. Keith must be numbered amongst the best line-out jumpers ever to don an Abergavenny jersey. Since his early youth days, he has enjoyed running with the ball and has played for Monmouthshire County and the Monmouthshire Union. Mark Lloyd, back row. Joined the club in 1976 from Abertillery, and at 6 feet and 14 and a half stone is a very talented player. Unfortunately, injuries have restricted Mark's first team appearances this season, but when things are going well, Mark is one of the best back row forwards in the club.
Well, at 2:42, with about 18 minutes to go before the kick-off today in this third round Welsh Rugby Union Schweppes Cup game between Abergavenny and Llanelli. The Llanelli 15 for today, our fullback Kevin Thomas, wings Phil Lewis and David Nicholas, centres Peter Morgan and Ray Gravel, Ray Gravel captain in Llanelli today in the absence of Phil May, halfbacks Bernard Thomas and Mark Douglas, the front row of Mike Lydiard, Kerry Townley and Lawrence Delaney, the second row of Phil Davis and Russell Cornelius, with the back row of Nick Sanders, Dave Pickering and Alan Davis. The replacements for Abergavenny, first of all, are the utility back replacement Mostyn Richards, prop forward replacement coach Tony McPherson. The replacement hooker is Andrew Goldsworthy, lock forward Keith Knight and back row Mark Lloyd. And Llanelli have named four replacements. They are Martin Gravel, Peter Hopkins, Gareth Davis and David Evans. The referee today is Mr. A.W. Bevan of Bryn Haman, with the touch judges Phil Jones and Evan Jenkins. And as the scoreboard reads, Llanelli and Abergavenny, 0-0. I'll just give a resume of Abergavenny's run through in the cup up to now. In the first round, they beat Abertillery at home by 13-9. In the second round, they were also at home again against NSD, which they beat 19-9. Then they played Llanarran, who they beat 10-3, also at home. Then they travelled away to Pembroke Dock, where they played Pembroke Dock Quins, and they beat them 18-0. To date, Abergavenny have scored 60 points for, with only 21 points scored against them. Even though coming here today is a wonderful occasion for the Abergavenny side to play against probably the best club side in world rugby, Llanelli must, after beating Swansea a fortnight ago, be one of the red-hot favourites to win this year's cup. They have an excellent record in the cup, having reached the finals in the first year, losing to Neath in 1972 by 15-9. Then in the following years, 1973, 74, 75, 76, Llanelli won the cup, beating Aberavenny twice, Swansea once, and Cardiff once. And the strong Abergavenny supporters, who hear it, they say well over 1,000. 15 buses has left Abergavenny this morning, and the crowd shout their applause to the Abergavenny side. And now Llanelli, led by Ray Gravel, with the Abergavenny crowd booing, take the field. So, the game is about to start. And Llanelli put in a long kick, taken here by Jeff Gardner, who puts the ball into touch on the Abergavenny 22. So, Mr. Bevan asking for a gap. And it's Kerry Townley feeds the ball. Mr. Bevan blows his whistle. All right, they'll take it again. It's Kerry Townley to feed this line out. It's a long ball tap back there by Russell Cornelius. Along to winger David Nick. Kevin Thomas to David Nick, and it's a try. Phil Lewis, the right winger. Well, an excellent ball from the line-out, won there by Russell Cornelius. Quick, clean passing with Kevin Thomas coming in to the centre, making the overlap for winger Phil Lewis to go over in the corner. And so we're a minute into the game, and already Llanelli are 4 points up, taking Abergavenny by surprise. Fullback Kevin Thomas places the ball. It's a kick of some 30 metres with the angle. He struck it well, and it's there. So, with a minute and a half gone, Llanelli lead by 6-0. So it's a restart. Exton kicks the ball long. It's taken there by Phil Davis. And Abergavenny win the ball. Inge into the centre. Nigel Evans. It's a kick through being chased.
Exton chasing back after Kevin Thomas. And it's Gardner who recovers the ball and kicks it into touch. Well, we saw a good clean ball won from a ruck there by Abergavenny. He had fullback for Llanelli, Kevin Thomas, and sent the ball deep into the Abergavenny 22. And it's a penalty. This time it is fullback Kevin Thomas to take the penalty kick. Kick of 22 metres. Strikes it well, will it come in? No, it's gone wide of the right hand upright. So Abergavenny lives again. And it's charged down there by David Pickering. Paul Exton then to kick this penalty, and he's found touch just inside of Llanelli half of the field. So once again we see the line out to be fed by the Llanelli hooker, Kerry Townley. And once again Cornelius taps the ball back, but the Abergavenny forwards are in there fighting. Wayne Trumper, Gareth Abbott, Peter Rozelle. Mr. Bevan says the ball's not coming out from there. We'll have a scrum down. Abergavenny to feed. So it's Jeff Garden to feed the ball. But Mr. Bevan has penalised the Llanelli front row for bringing his opposition down. So it's a penalty kick here. The penalty kick this time at goal from something like 45 metres. Struck it well, it's climbing and it's just dropped short, taken there by fullback Kevin Thomas and kicked into touch. So we'll have a line out inside the Llanelli half of the field. This time we see the Abergavenny hooker Brian Clark to feed the line out. Once again Cornelius wins. Gravel with the ball to Morgan. And it's a good tackle there from centre Nigel Evans. The ball being dribbled on by Di James. Nice bit of work there by Abergavenny. Upset in the rhythm of the Llanelli three quarters. And it looks as if there's an injury to an Abergavenny player. The referee calling on the trainer to have a look at Terry Richards, back row forward. Terry, who is a product of Newport Youth, he played four seasons with Pontypool and he had two seasons with Ebervale. He also captained Abergavenny in 1979-80 season. And Terry's okay and he goes to his place in the back of the line-out. Mr. Bevan making sure that the gap is there. And it's a short one to the front. And Abergavenny pile in and Gardner wins the ball. A long ball back to Inge. Misses out. Kevin Neal. Neal dribbles on. And finally it's Phil Lewis who kicks the ball into touch to save Llanelli. And it's a shortened line out here by Abergavenny. Trumper and Havard. Havard wins the ball. believes Nick Sanders came through there. It's a knock on, so it's a scrum down. Mark Douglas feeds the ball. Flathley won the scrum, but Mr. Bevan not happy with what was happening in the front row. Penalising Abergavenny. Bernard Thomas kicks the ball. Into touch, close to the 10-metre line, inside his own half of the field. Fluff that early. Quick try by Llanelli. Abergavenny have settled down and are more than holding their own up front. Clark feeds. And the ball is won by Phil Davis. He's turned. The ball's back. And it's a knock on here by Bernard Thomas. No advantage, so it's a scrum down. Abergavenny to feed. So once again, Phil Gardner. And there's a little bit of hanky-panky going on here in the front row. Mike Lydiard and Peter Rustell. They finally settled down. Gardner to feed. And Llanelli are trying out this Abergavenny front row. But Mr. Bevan is going to bring him up and have a word with him. Tell him exactly what he wants. Down they go again. And it's a penalty against Llanelli. And once again, fullback Paul Exton comes up, kicks a short one. Puts a low kick through, taken there by winger Dave Nicholas, and it's sent back into touch on the 10-metre line inside the left half of the field. The close-up of the front row there on the line-out, Wayne Trumper, Alan Jones, Gareth Havard behind Trumper. Trumper wins the ball. The ball is kicked into touch. So we'll have another line out, this time inside the Abergavenny half of the field. Mike Lydiard and Lawrence Delaney, Phil Davis and Russell Cornelius are the first four there. Number eight, Alan Davis has been brought down to stand at five in the line out. Cornelius wins it. Mr. Bevan isn't happy with that. Barging in a line-out, so it's a penalty decision against Abergavenny once again in a kickable position here. Fourth and Ethley. And it's fullback Kevin Thomas who comes up to attempt this kick of goal. Thomas has already missed a penalty from a shorter distance than this. Will he be lucky enough to put this one between the uprights? Some booing from some of the Abergavenny supporters as Thomas takes his run up, strikes the ball well, and it's another 3 points to Llanelli. So we're 13 minutes into the game and Llanelli lead by 9 points to nil. So it's once again Paul Exton to restart. It's a low driving kick. Knocked on there by Nick Sanders. Referee allowing advantage. The ball is being dribbled through there by Kevin Neal. Abergavenny's left winger quickly up on that loose ball, sending his side deep into the Llanelli 22. So Clark to feed the line out. Short run one in the front there by Mike Lydiard for Llanelli. Abergavenny in there searching for it. Number four, Phil Davis, has been brought to the ground, so the referee, Mr. Bevan, blows up for a scrum down. So, Gardner with the ball to feed. Clark has won it, but Llanelli are wheeling the scrum, picked up at the back there by Mike Williams. He's being supported by Terry Richards. Trumper, Harvard, all in there. Gardner. And this is Abergavenny ball, but well, the ball was there for Abergavenny, but it was taken back in, so Mr. Bevan has called for another scrum. Once again, with Abergavenny to feed through their inside half, Jeff Gardner. And Gardner's feed, Clark has won it. His ball picked up there by number 8, Mike Williams, out to Gardner. Williams is caught in possession by the Llanelli pack. But Abergavenny are driving through and disrupting the Llanelli 8. Good work there by Abergavenny. Williams and Gardner working well at the base of the scrums. Once again, it is inside half, Jeff Gardner feeding the ball into the scrum. This time Gardner picks up, feeds to Inge. It's a long pass over his head, causing trouble as the Llanelli back row crowd in, but it's gone straight out, so it's a line out. Right on the Llanelli 22. Kerry Townley to feed. Tap back there by Phil Davis. The ball put away by Mark Douglas. Inching his side further down the field. Llanelli not having it all their own way up front. Once again, Brian Clark to feed the line out. It's a long one this time. David Pickering falls on the board, but one of the Abergavenny players has come over the top, killing the ruck. Mr. Bevan penalising Abergavenny. Bernard Thomas to take the penalty kick. And he finds touch halfway between the Abergavenny 22 and 10 metre lines. Brian Clark waiting for his instructions as he feeds the ball to the line-out. Short one there, but still can Llanelli take it. Gravel. Gravel breaks through, tackled wonderfully there by Nigel Evans. And now Abergavenny staunch that attack. The ball is finally kicked into touch by John Gunter. So it's a line out on the halfway line. A quick one here, one by Cornelius, tap back to Douglas. But Venny breakthrough, the whistle blows. A little bit of untidy play there by both sides. Mark Douglas to feed. Douglas feeds, it's a quick heel. Held in there by Alan Davis. Thomas with the ball. Throws to Gravel, misses out Morgan. Gravel runs back into his 22. And kicks the ball straight into the hands of Di James. Abergavenny piling on the pressure. There's ball there to be won. And it's a penalty against Llanelli. A little bit of trouble there. Mr. Bevan, right on the spot to break it up. This is sad for rugby. Abergavenny and Llanelli, you can't say who's to blame, but the boys play the rugby and leave the fighting alone. I think it'll be a much, much better day to remember. Mr. Bevan has called both captains across. He's not having this sort of play. The Abergavenny hooker, Brian Clark, is injured on the touchline, and Mr. Bevan singles for the trainer to come on as he calls Ray Gravel and Nigel Evans together to tell them, look, boys, this is a cup game. We know what's happening. Let's cool it. Let's play a game of rugby. He's probably saying that any more of this, the next man he finds breaking the laws will find himself having an early shower. Clark back on his feet. And Abergavenny put in a little bit of pressure on the Llanelli 15. Mr. Bevan still in the centre talking to both captains. Right, now as Gravel goes back to Llanelli and Evans goes to Abergavenny to tell them exactly what the referee has just told them. Let's hope that after this discussion we'll see good, open, clean rugby. So it's a penalty attempt once again by Paul Exton. Taking the ball back outside the 22 metre line. It's a kick of about 24 metres. Already in these cup rounds, Exton has scored 8 points through 2 penalties and 1 conversion. Exton quite used to playing first class rugby, having played for Pontypool and Abertillery. In everyday life, Exton is a quantity surveyor. So he surveys the senior as he steps back for this penalty attempt. Everything is hushed in the stand. Exton strikes it well, narrowly missing it as the ball curls past the right hand upright. And the ball is taken there by John Gunter. Thrown out to the wing, Kevin Neal, who was caught there by his opposite number, David Nicholas. The Abergavenny forwards swarm around like wasps. The ball has gone dead. Referee, Mr. Bevan, Bryn Ammon, calling for a scrum down with the advantage to Abergavenny. Once again, inside half, Jeff Gardner to feed. Quick heel there by Brian Clark, held at the back there by Mike Williams. Gardner picks up, puts in a high kick to no avail because it's gone straight out, so we'll have a line out. In fact, it's a penalty for offside. Offside there by a back row player, Llanelli. I think it was Nick Sanders. And once again, Exton finds a good touch deep inside the Llanelli half of the field, right down on their goal line. So here is a supreme chance for Abergavenny if they can win the ball from this line out. And the ball is won there, I think, by Cornelius, but it's a penalty decision for an Abergavenny player barging his way through the line out. So Bernard Thomas to relieve his side's line. And he's not found touch. It's picked up here by Kevin Neal, who steps, or tries to step outside Phil Lewis. The ball is running loose. But Gary Innes, the Abergavenny outside half, is across it quickly to run the ball dead into touch. So it's just line out just inside the Abergavenny half of the field. Kelly Townley once again to feed. It's a long ball, a tap by number 8 Alan Davis, picked up by Phil Davis. Mark Douglas waiting, they're going blind. He has support with Dave Pickering outside him. He finds Phil Davis, who storms towards the line being tackled there, but it was a forward pass to winger Phil Lewis. A good run there by Phil Davis. An equally good tackle there by John Gunter. Scrum down halfway between the Abergavenny 22 and goal line. But it's a penalty put up against Llanelli. Gardner throws the ball to Paul Exton. Exton about to relieve the Abergavenny situation. And he finds touch on the halfway line. Excellent touch here, considering the angle which he had to play with. It's a quick one, but no, the referee's not happy with that. One or two players, I think, offside there as well, so we'll have a scrum down. Gardner to feed the scrum. Held there by Mike Williams. Gardner out to Gary Inge. Inge puts in a high kick, but it's gone straight out, so we'll have a line out from where he kicked it. It's a reduced line out, ball one. Douglas with the ball, out to Thomas. Finds David Pickering, who immediately gives the ball to Alan Davis. Nick Sanders there as well, but Venny are fighting for the ball. Trumper, Havard, Jeff Williams, Terry Richards, they're all there looking for it. Gardner finds the ball, throws it back. And it's a good clearance there by fullback Exon. But anyway, the ball has been won now by Russell Cornelius. It's a penalty against Llanelli. For tackling eye, and the referee having warned the players once, has taken them on another 10 metres. Alan Davis throwing a punch at Terry Richards. Davis has cost his cycling athlete quite a lot of ground here, putting Paul Exton once again in a kickable position. The Abergavenny crowd opened at this time. In fact, it's Inge who's taking the kick, and he struck it well. Well, he had the distance and the height, but unfortunately the angle was just off. So it's a dropout 22 to Llanelli. Bernard Thomas dropped the ball. It's a good ball there. Won by Trumper, but it's knocked on by Russell Cornelius. The referee allowing play to go on. Cornelius trapped on the wrong side. Finds his way around to the right side. But no, the ball's not coming out. So it's a scrum down with the advantage to Abergavenny. Options open here to Gardner. If they win the ball, the blind side or the open. Williams picks up. Out to Gardner. Gardner puts a grubber through, but it's covered here by Bernard Thomas. The ball is still in play. Picked up by Paul Exton. And as David Nicholas harasses him, he finds touch close to the Abergavenny 10-metre line. Cornelius wins. So along the backs, Gravel throws the ball to Kevin Thomas, who was coming in but missed it. Abergavenny retrieved the ball. Gunter being held up by Pickering. You know, Mr. Bevan calls for a scrum down. Well, Llanelli, one good ball there. A misunderstanding between Ray Gravel and Kevin Thomas, who called to come into the line but overrun himself. Clark having trouble getting in position to attempt to hook this ball. It's a clean hook, but Llanelli wheeled the scrum. Picked up there by Williams, who was immediately tackled by his opposite number, Alan Davis. But the Venny are through. And the ball has gone to ground, and it's dead, and it's a scrum down with the advantage to Abergavenny. The Abergavenny 8 are working perfectly in unison as a strong 8, and I think it's causing some worry to the Llanelli pack. And it's foot up there, feeding the ball, in fact, into the second row. So it's a penalty against Abergavenny. Bernard Thomas to take the penalty just inside his own half of the field. And he strikes the ball well, and he finds touch just inside the Abergavenny 22. So it's Brian Clark feeding the ball, and it's tapped back there from the front by Lawrence Delaney. But once again, there's a mix-up in the three quarters. Bernard Thomas, in fact, tried to pass to Gravel, dropped the ball, but recovered it, and now has run back into the Abergavenny pack with his players in support, but he's been taken to ground. The ball's dead. It's a scrum down with the Abergavenny side losing the advantage to Llanelli. Well, there's been several misunderstandings already between the Llanelli three quarters. the ball they're getting. Appears to be good ball, but it's not working out for them so far. So it's Douglas to feed. And Gavenny is taking one against the head there. Alan Davis. Nick Sanders, in fact, was the man who threw the ball to his inside half, Mark Douglas, eh? But Mr. Bevan not happy with the way the scrum collapsed, so he's asked him to retake it. This time it's Abergavenny pushing well, but the ball is at Douglas's feet. Trapped there by Gardner. Inge kicks the ball through. Phil Lewis chases back, finds his fullback, Kevin Thomas. Thomas sidesteps through three or four players. Still going strongly, looking for support, and finds it. The ball with Peter Morgan. Gravel. A bad pass at Gravel's feet. Mr. Bevan judging it a knock on. Of course, we're a scrum down. Mr. Bevan making sure everything's all right up front. We saw the full shove there of the Llanelli 8. So this time it's Mark Douglas to feed, and they're wheeling before the ball is in. Mark Douglas to feed, and it's won there by Townley. Douglas out to Gravel. Gravel looking for support. He goes through the middle, through two men. It's a long pass out to Phil Lewis on the wing, but the ball has been lost on the Abergavenny goal line. A nice slicing run there by Ray Gravel, looking for support and finding it with Phil Lewis. So it's a scrum down on the corner flag close to the Abergavenny goal line. And what's been awarded there? In fact, Mr. Bevan has awarded a try. I'm not sure who scored it. It was Douglas, the inside half. So Abergavenny go further behind, 13 points after 34 minutes. It's a kick of some 35, 36 metres with the angle. Strikes it well, but no, it's not there. So the score is 13 points to nil in favour of Llanelli. With about 7 or 8 minutes of this first half to go, Exton drops out too deep for his own forwards. The ball taken in by Cornelius, thrown out back to Douglas. Douglas finds Bernard Thomas, and Thomas immediately finds touch on the halfway line. Abergavenny are lacking in height and are struggling to win any ball from the lineouts against men like Russell Cornelius and Phil Davis. But it's a long ball back to number 7, Pickering. Pickering look for Douglas, finds Douglas, throws the ball forward, hoping that Bernard Thomas would run onto it. But Mr. Bevan has blown his whistle and called for a scrum down with the advantage of Llanelli. Llanelli front row of Mike Lydiard, Kerry Townley and Lawrence Delaney. There we are. So it's Mark Douglas, and there's a bit of trouble now between Delaney and Alan Jones, the loose and tight head props. And the ball going out on the full there by Phil Lewis. It's a line out to Abergavenny. Brian Clark lofts the ball in. It's knocked back onto the Llanelli side. Bernard Thomas, Gravel, Morgan. Up to Nicholas, who knocks on once again. No advantage. No advantage, says Mr. Bevan. He'll have a scrum down, Abergavenny ball. Well, once again, good clean ball, and David Nicholas appeared to take his eye off the ball, only to knock it on once again. Gardner feeds. The ball is won by Clark, held by Mike Williams. Gardner to Inge. Inge kicks in a low penetrating kick into the Llanelli 22, picked up by Phil Lewis. Lewis, Harris by his opposite number. James, and finally finds touch. Trumper on Avid against Cornelius Davis. And it's won there by Abergavenny. It's a long ball out to the wing. And they're in trouble. No support there. A very lethargic play there by Abergavenny. Everyone wanted to watch someone else with the ball instead of supporting. They were let off very lightly there. Scrum down. With the advantage going to Llanelli. Mark Douglas receives the ball off Jeff Gardner. Douglas finds the ball. Feeds it out to Thomas. Thomas Gravel. Thomas back. Looks for Lewis. Lewis overrun himself and the ball has been thrown into touch. Llanelli trying to work the blind side there, only to complicate it for themselves after the loop move between Gravel and Thomas. Wing, Phil Lewis, overran. Clark feeds, won by Cornelius. Douglas finds Thomas. Gravel charging through, looking for support. Gone through three or four men. This time he's caught by the Abergavenny back row of Williams and Williams. But the ball now is with winger David Nicholas, who this time catches the ball. Only to be forced into touch by his opposite number. Winger David James. James forces Nicholas out. And there's another injury down there. That's an Abergavenny player. And it looks to be the winger David James who put on the tackle on David Nicholas. Looks as if he's injured himself. A fine covering tackle here by young David James. I say young, he's been with the club since 1969, in fact. He's scored over 130 tries for Abergavenny and is one of the senior players. He also played for Pontypool Athletic. And he scored a try in the WRU Cup already this year against Innisdee. But it's a scrum down. Close to the Abergavenny goal line on the left-hand side of the field. Gardner feeds. Picks it up and runs himself, looking for support, but he's tackled and sent into touch by Saunders. So Kerry Townley to feed the ball. This is one that Cornelius and Davis will be looking to win for their side. It's a long one. Tap back, picked up by Alan Davis. The ball is with Ray Gravel. Gravel to Morgan. Morgan tackle here by Gunter. The ball is loose. Picked up by winger Neil. The Abergavenny forwards are getting there rather late. Llanelli are driving them on. It's all over the Abergavenny line. Mr. Bevan is waiting to see what's happening. No, there's no try there. It's a scrum five. Fed out to Douglas. Douglas held there by Williams. But finally, to try for Llanelli. So it's Thomas with the conversion attempt. Strikes the ball hard and low. And wide. David Pickering did score the try, and as the referee blows for half time, with the score standing at 17 points to nil. Scores come in by Llanelli through Kevin Thomas with a penalty, Phil Lewis with a try. And we hear that at half time, Swansea and Newport are drawing 9-all. Aberavenny 10, Neath 18. Bridgend 3, Maesteg 0. And Pontypool are leading South Wales Institute by 18 points to 4. Going back to the scores, as I said, Kevin Thomas has kicked a penalty, Phil Lewis has scored a try, Mark Douglas has scored a try, and Di Pickering has scored a try. Bernard Thomas has kicked one conversion. So it's Axon to restart. He kicks a long ball. It's picked up there by winger Phil Lewis. So it's a line out on the Llanelli 10-meter line. Long ball, one there by number 8, Alan Davis, along the backs, Gravel to Morgan. Morgan finding Kevin Thomas in the line. Outside Kevin Thomas we have David Nicholas, who is almost stopped but finally bundled into touch by 3 Abergavenny players. A good long penetrating run there, right from their own 10-meter line, right to the Abergavenny goal line by Llanelli, who will really mean business this half by the look of it. Fullback Kevin Thomas coming into that line there. Douglas wins the ball. Throws it back to Thomas, who sidesteps, goes blind, looking for support. Caught up there by the Abergavenny front row. And finally bundled into touch. It's a long one there, and it's, well, it was originally won by Abergavenny, but it's back now with Douglas, who's fallen to the ground. Kicked through there by Wayne Trumper. And it's a penalty. It's a penalty as once again we see a little bit of trouble flaring up, which is unwanted. This time Mr. Bevan, I feel, will have to make some sort of movement to stop in this. He's already warned him in the first half. Brian Clark has been called, and also the number 8 for Llanelli, Alan Davis. He's having a word with both of them, and he's telling them any more nonsense, and they'll be having their marching orders. So it's a penalty for Llanelli. Thomas with the ball. Kicks it high and long and finds touch just inside the Abergavenny 22. So once again, Clark to feed the lineouts. Cornelius to Douglas. Thomas misses out. Morgan to Gravel. Thomas, Kevin Thomas once again tried to come in the line, but Gravel was held up there by Evans for Abergavenny. The ball is loose, but it's on the Llanelli side. Douglas looks for it. The ball is back in Douglas's hands. He throws it out, this time to Morgan. Kevin Thomas puts in a Gary Owen, but the ball is dead over the Abergavenny line, so we'll have a dropout 22 to Abergavenny. Paul Exton with the dropout 22. High ball taken here by the Cornelius and Davis. Falkland after the ball went back in the hands of Mark Douglas, who sends a grubber through, but the ball is once again gone dead, and it's a dropout 22 to Abergavenny. Appears to be a shoulder injury. Ray Gravel going across to find out exactly what the injury is. And some shouting here from the crowd as number 3, Lawrence Delaney, puts on a brand new pair of shorts. Eyeball. One once again by Cornelius. Back to Douglas. Douglas to Thomas. Thomas loops with Gravel. Gravel looking for the blind side, and he's through two men. Tries to go through winger Kevin Neal, but he's finally bundled into touch by the Abergavenny back row of Richards and Williams. And I think there's yet another Abergavenny injury. And this time it's Wayne Trumper who was injured. Trumper was played for Abergavenny, and Bonnie
Trumper is all right as he takes his place in the second row of the Abergavenny pack.
Gardner to feed. And it's being wheeled by Llanelli, picked up by Williams. Williams is held there by his opposite number, Alan Davis. Nick Sanders, Dowie Picker in there. Venny and Llanelli fighting for this ball. And there's one or two players offside there. And the referee, Mr. Bevan, quick to come around to make sure that there's no hanky-panky as it collapses. Mike Williams picked the ball up there as it was wheeled. Caught by his opposite number, Alan Davis. So it's a scrum down. Front row being warned again. It's a scrum down with Douglas to feed. Douglas feeds. Ball being held in at the back. Gavenny are pushing. It's a good shot, but it's picked up finally by Nick Sanders. Gardner caught in possession. And the ball kicked into touch by Alan Davis. So we see a line out close to the Abergavenny 22 metre line. And it's one there. Douglas Harris there by the Abergavenny back. Oh, the ball kicked on by Terry Richards into the hands of Phil Lewis. But Mr. Bevan had already blown his whistle. And it's a scrum down right in front of the stands on the halfway line. Gardner feeds. Once again, Llanelli wheel. Mike Williams keeps the ball at his feet. Gardner picks up. Finds outside half Inge. Inge puts an eyeball in. Kevin Thomas running in. Catches the ball well and he's clear. Thomas looking for support. Finds it with Rick Revell. Oh, in fact it was David Nicholas who supported him. Not Rick Revell. But the ball has been kicked through by an Abergavenny player. And it's 14, Phil Lewis, who relieves the pressure for Llanelli. Finding touch halfway between his 22 and 10 metre line. Nicholas created an opportunity for themselves down on that left wing, but once again we saw a knock on. So it's Clark to feed the line out. A long ball. Mr. Bevan allowing it to go on. It's being picked up by Sanders, who rushes through the Abergavenny side. He's tackled by Alan Jones. Mr. Bevan penalising Abergavenny. Bernard Thomas with a penalty. And he finds touch on the Abergavenny 10 metre line. Some of the Abergavenny supporters feel that their side were outdone by that decision of the penalty, but nevertheless, the referee was far closer than any of us. It's a long ball picked up the back there, fed out to Gravel. Gravel tackled there by Nigel Evans. And it's Morgan who kicks the ball into his own player. Peter Morgan kicked the ball into the back of David Nicholas. Mr. Bevan calling him back for a scrum down. And this arguing, Abergavenny have been penalised for arguing with the referee. Mark Douglas passes the ball out to Bernard Thomas. Mr. Bevan not having any nonsense at all now. And Thomas finds touch close to the Abergavenny 22 line. Good view there of Lawrence Delaney and Phil Davis. Russell Cornelius behind him, then Alan Davis, Nick Sanders, David Pickering. An infringement at the line out there. So the athlete penalised for it.
So it's a chance for Abergavenny through their fullback Paul Exton to release some of this pressure. Exton strikes it well, but hasn't found touch. The ball is being picked up there by 15 Kevin Thomas, who is looking for support. He's gone three or four men. Finds support there from David Pickering. Pickering finds winger Nicholas outside him. Nicholas held up there by the Venny side, but this time it's Gravel with the ball. Gravel finds Bernard Thomas. Thomas once again finding Phil Lewis overrunning him, and the ball going into touch. We've seen a lot of this afternoon with Llanelli winning good ball, the centres being overrun by their wingers. We're a quarter an hour into this second half and the score still stands at Llanelli 17 points to nil. And it's a penalty decision against Llanelli. Barging in the line-out. Once again, Paul Exton has the job of clearing the ball into touch. This time, he's successful with a very good touch. Close to the Llanelli 22-metre line. Good kick there by fullback Exton. So it's Kerry Townley to feed this line out. Davis knocks the ball as Trumper jumps against him. And finally it's Sanders that sends one of the Abergavenny players, in fact, Harvard, into touch with the ball. This time Cornelius wins the ball. And the ball has been held for Mark Douglas. It's come out. It's a penalty decision, I think, for an offside offence against Abergavenny. Thomas to clear the line. Finds touch on the halfway line. This time, Llanelli have penalised for being offside. Paul Exton calling for the ball, and he's going to... It's Gary Inge, in fact, the Abergavenny outside half, who is attempting this kick. Struck it well, but it's not hard enough. The ball is with Ray Gravel from his own half. Gravel looking for support, finds it through Mark Douglas. Douglas feeds back into Peter Morgan. Morgan goes through the four plays back to Gravel. Gravel finds Kevin Thomas, the fullback. Thomas in supported by Peter Morgan. But the ball adjudged to have gone forward. So it's a scrum down just inside the Abergavenny half of the field. Enterprising run there by Greg Gravel, being supported by his inside half Mark Douglas and centre Peter Morgan. Also fullback Kevin Thomas. But Abergavenny had the ball. Gardner out to Inge. And it's along the centres. Gunter Evans. And a grubber sent through, being picked up there by winger Phil Lewis. Mark Douglas, sorry. But Abergavenny win the ball, but it's a touch judge over that side is Evan Jenkins. And it's a line out with the advantage going to Llanelli. Townley throws, won by Cornelius. Kick through by Abergavenny boots. And it's a drop out 22. Fullback Kevin Thomas touches the ball down. Strikes it well. Ball won there by Trumper, supported by Abbott, Williams, Richards, all there. Nice bit of play down the blind side there for Abergavenny. Now you know, putting the pressure on Llanelli with a line out halfway between Llanelli's 22 and goal line. This time the advantage going to Abergavenny. Brian Clark to feed the line out. Rastell and Jones standing 2 and 3 in the line-out. And it's back on the Llanelli side, picked up there by Mark Douglas. Referee Mr. Bevan blows his whistle and calls for a scrum down. 10 yards in. Douglas to feed the scrum men for Llanelli. And once again, the front rows have collapsed. So we'll try again. Douglas feeds and it's a penalty against Abergavenny. So it's Thomas with the ball. And he finds touch on the 10-meter line. Reduced line out. Trumper and Avid in there for Abergavenny. Trumper wins the ball. Caught there by Nick Sanders, but there's no support. Douglas runs away with the ball. Finds out Bernard Thomas. Morgan to Gravel. And once again, the ball being knocked forward by a Llanelli three quarter. Abergavenny late getting there, but finally managing to push a Llanelli attack into touch. I think Mr. Bevan is calling back for the knock on. Gardner to feed. Ball at the feet of Mike Williams. Picked up there by Williams. Williams supported by Jeff Williams, Teddy Richards, Rastell, Trumper. But once again, Mr. Bevan's whistle goes early. Just as the ball was about to be retrieved by Jeff Gardner. Jeff, brother of former Ebervale captain Phil Gardner. Jeff himself having played for Ebervale on several occasions. Ball being held there by the back row. Williams and Richards fighting, being supported by Abbott, Trumper, Alan Jones. Clark is in there. And the Abergavenny side once again forced Llanelli into touches. Number 7, Di Pickering, has a word or two with one of the Abergavenny players. Jeff Gardner, the top try scorer in the WRU Cup this year for Abergavenny, with 3 tries, having scored him against Abertillery, Innes D and Flanaran. It's a long ball at the back of the line out. Tapped down there by Mike Williams, but it's picked up by Pickering. It's a good run here through by Lawrence Delaney. Delaney being supported by number 8, Alan Davis. Finally the ball going into touch. Mr. Bevan has called for a scrum down for a knock on. And there appears to be an injury this time to a Llanelli player, is it? No, it's an Abergavenny player that's injured, isn't it? Trumper, it looks like. Second row forward, Wayne Trumper. And also one of the Llanelli players appears, I think it's Lawrence Delaney. Lawrence, who had a nice run there for a prop, a run of some 20, 25 yards. So it's a scrum down with Gardner to feed the scrum. Close to his own 22. Gardner out to Inge. Inge looks for touch. Strikes the ball well. And finds touch close to the halfway line. So we're just inside the Llanelli half of the field. Kerry Townley to feed this line out. There's a good view there of Wayne Trumper, the man who was injured just now. Standing in front of him is prop forward Alan Jones. Ball won there by Russell Cornelius. And the ball is with Peter Morgan. Peter Morgan looking, and he's running through 3 or 4 Abergavenny players. Finally caught there by Terry Richards. Ball back on Llanelli's side. Picked up there by Nick Sanders. Sanders caught in possession and penalised for not releasing the ball, for failing to get to his feet, holding the ball in. It's a penalty against back row forward Nick Sanders. So once again, Paul Exton, the Abergavenny fullback, is attempting a penalty from something like 48 metres, I should imagine.
Abergavenny
strikes the ball fairly well, but it's dropping just short. He had the direction right, but it's Gravel running the ball from his own half of the field. Steps inside three or four players, supported by his back row. They are caught up by the Abergavenny back row. And number six, in fact, Saunders in an offside position there. But Mr. Bevan not saying anything. And it's finally a scrum down on the 10-metre line inside the Llanelli half of the field, with the advantage going to Llanelli. This time Abergavenny trying to turn Llanelli forwards, and the ball is picked up there by number 8, Alan Davis. He's been supported by Phil Davis and Russell Cornelius. The ball is back in Gravel's hands. Gravel running up the blind side. Support this time from Kevin Thomas. Thomas bundled into touch. A little bit of fun there. Penalty against Llanelli. So Abergavenny looking for a kick to the corner this time, I think. Trying to gain territorial advantage. It's a loose kick, it's not into touch, it's picked up there by Davis. Along to Kevin Thomas, who sends a long penetrating kick back. Picked up there by Evans. The Abergavenny player is caught now by a full squad of Scarlet forwards. Out once again to Ray Gravel. Gravel looking for room through. Finds number 7, Di Pickering, outside him. Pickering almost fell. He feeds to number 14, Phil Lewis. Lewis still with the ball. Throws the ball behind Peter Morgan. But picked up again by Di Pickering, who is looking for a way through. There's no way through, though. He goes to the ground, and the ball is found once again by Douglas, who finds Phil Lewis clear. And Lewis going in for his second try, but no. The linesman on this side, Phil Jones, has his flag eye, calling Phil Lewis back for placing his foot in touch. The Llanelli crowd not very happy with that decision. There's a line out with Brian Clark to feed. The ball back with Kerry Townley, supported here by Mike Lydiard, Lawrence Delaney, but the whistle is gone. For killing the ball, Abergavenny players lying over the top. Penalty to Llanelli. Also an injured player there on the Abergavenny side. Peter Ristel. Tight head pop, Ristel, with an ankle injury, it looks like. So they're trying to tap penalty. Douglas with a long ball back to Thomas. Thomas to Gravel. Gravel back to number 6, Nick Saunders. Alan Davis here with him. Davis picks up, trying to find a way through. He's held up here by one or two Abergavenny players. But Llanelli there now in full song. The ball is being held in there by Alan Davis, the Llanelli number 8. Abergavenny are looking for it. Yes, says Lawrence Delaney, I can see the ball. But it ends up with a scrum 5. It's Mark Douglas to feed. Ball being held in there by Nick Saunders. So long ball out to Ray Gravel. Gravel looking for way through. There's no way through, says Abergavenny. And now the ball is once again with Di Pickering. But Pickering loses the ball. Ball thrown forward. Mr. Bevan blowing his whistle immediately. It's an injury, I think, to Di Pickering. It's hard to tell from the angle at which he's standing. Jeff Gardner asking if he's all right. Pickering takes his place on the blind side of the scrum. Gardner feeds. Ball won there by Clark. Held at the back by Williams. Gardner to Inge. Inge being harassed by his opposite number, Bernard Thomas.
finds Kevin Thomas. Thomas lifted there by good tackle by Gary Inge. Abergavenny now are there much quicker than these Llanelli's forwards. It's a penalty against number six, Nick Saunders. And the crowd are applauding Abergavenny, who have decided to run the ball from inside their own half, halfway between their 22 and 10 yard line. Gardner with the ball being picked up by Rustell, being supported by Gardner. Gardner puts a right foot kick over the top. But the ball being adjudged to have gone in directly. So they call back for a line out just inside the Abergavenny half of the field, close to the 10 metre line. Standing in number three is Lawrence Delaney. Behind him we have Phil Davis and Mike Glidiard, but it's won there by Cornelius. And it's lost. Coming around on the wrong side there. Barging their way through by Abergavenny. It's a penalty to Llanelli. Bernard Thomas with the ball. And he strikes it well and sends the ball deep into the Abergavenny 22. So once again, Abergavenny hooker Brian Clark to feed this line out. One there by Townley. The ball is in the hands of Gravel. Gravel winding his way through the centre, being held up once again though. Supported there by number eight, Alan Davis, who is brought to ground by Jeff Williams. As Paul Exton, I think the Abergavenny fullback, received a nasty... It's Gary Inge, in fact, the outside half, who received a nasty kick in the ankle there. As the powerful number eight, Alan Davis, attempted to wind his way through to the Abergavenny goal line. Well, Abergavenny has put up a very, very good performance today, I think. Playing one of the strongest club sides in world rugby. To hold them to 0-0 in the second half of this game must be a feather in the hat of the Abergavenny players and their coach, Tony McPherson. Not to mention the strong support they've had from their own town, with over 1,000 people coming here today to watch this game. The ball is back to Inge, out to Evans. And he finds touch close to his own 22. Long ball picked up by Dive Pickering. Pickering held up there by Inge, supported again by Alan Davis. The ball with Ray Gravel, and there's an overlap here for 14, Phil Lewis. And Lewis is over in the corner. But he dropped the ball. In fact, it's a forward pass, says Mr. Bevan. You know, he dropped the ball going over. I was right first time. So it's a dropout 22 for losing the ball over the try line. Ball in the hands of Di James. Feeds it back to Paul Exton. It's a lower one. Exton, one there by Alan Davis. If any players come in, Saunders taken to the ground there without the ball. Mr. Bevan asking for a scrum down. Advantage to Abergavenny. Wait till the ball's in before you shove, says Mr. Bevan. Gardner trying to get both scrums straight, and the ball was kicked through there, in fact, by Lawrence Delaney. Llanelli have wheeled them. And Abergavenny are wheeling them back. Williams, the ball is beat. Gardner to Inge, who finds touch close to the halfway line inside the Abergavenny half of the field. Quick throw in there by number two, Kerry Townley. The ball back in the hands of Bernard Thomas, only to be dropped by Ray Gravel. So yet another knock on by the anxious Llanelli players.
Scrum just now, just inside the Llanelli half of the field. Ball not going in, says Mr. Bevan. We'll take that again. Garden at the feed. And there's a little bit of fun going on there. Once again between the props, Alan Jones and Lawrence Delaney. And it's a penalty against Llanelli for not allowing the ball to be put in. So it's just about a metre inside the Llanelli half of the field. And Abergavenny have opted for a set piece. The ball at the feet of Gardner. Gardner with the ball. Picked up there by Williams. Jeff Williams bursting through, looking for support on the right there. And he finds support. The ball out there with Di James. Di James looking for support inside him. They're close and it's... It looks like a try. The linesman has his flag up. And in fact, it is a line out. Good play there by Abergavenny. They deserved a try for that move. Ball won by Cornelius. But Abergavenny penalised, barging in the line out. Well, I think Abergavenny deserved 4 points there. Good support by the Abergavenny three quarters. Started from a move by wing forward Jeff Williams from a set piece. Well, here we are. With 4 or 5 minutes of the game left to be played, or perhaps less. It's a line out. The ball in the hands of Brian Clark. Clark throws a long one. Gravel tries to pick it up, but the ball is knocked back there as the Abergavenny players, Williams, Trumper, Avid, Clark, Jones, all fight for the ball, but it's back in the hands of Mark Douglas. An interception there. Interception by captain Nigel Evans. And Nigel Evans has scored a try. A wonderful try as the Abergavenny supporters rise to this interception. It's 4 points. An opportunist try. And who better to score it than the Abergavenny captain, Nigel Evans. That's Evans' second try in the Schweppes Cup this season. He also scored one against Innisdee. So fullback Paul Exton. Trying to make Nigel Evans' try into a goal with the penalty attempt. Crowd rushed. Strikes it well, and it's there. 6 points to Abergavenny. So, Llanelli now lead by 17 points to 6. With me, I have an Abergavenny player, Adrian Green. Well, what do you think of the try, Adrian?
Nigel Evans accepted the ball very gratefully from Mark Douglas. Said thank you very much, and sprinted 22 metres to score a fine try.
Thank you, John Arlott.
at the restart. Llanelli coming back really hard, looking for the ball now. It's a scrum down. 12 metres inside the Abergavenny half of the field. Mark Douglas trying to get the scrums straight as he feeds the ball in. Abergavenny trying to wheel, but the ball is being held at the back there by Davis for Llanelli. And it's a penalty against Abergavenny. And they're trying to a quick one. Douglas with the ball to Thomas. To Gravel. Gravel looking. Kevin Thomas is with him. Thomas through the middle. Chips the ball over the top. And the ball is finally cleared and kicked dead there by John Gunter. So it's a scrum five with the advantage going to the attacking side. Mark Douglas to feed the ball into this scrum. 5 yards from the 5 metres, I should say. Now we've gone metric. 5 metres from the Abergavenny goal line. Llanelli looks to one it. Douglas out to Thomas. Thomas to Morgan. Morgan with a long ball out there to Cornelius. Sorry, to Nicholas. Cornelius not playing today. But finally, Abergavenny managed to clear their line. And the ball is still alive, says Mr. Bevan. It's Gary Inch chasing the ball back as number 11, Di Nicholas, comes back to save Llanelli. Good tackle there by Jeff Gardner. Also, Mike Williams well up there. Abergavenny have their tails up as they move now into the Llanelli 22. Long ball. One there by Alan Davis for Llanelli. Abergavenny tried to disrupt the ball. And it's a scrum down. Well, Llanelli won good ball, but Abergavenny wouldn't allow him to send the ball along the three quarters. Mark Douglas with the ball. Scrum on the 22-metre line. Douglas, long ball back here to Kevin Thomas. Thomas finds touch. Once again, then it's Clark to feed the line out. Middle ball, one there by Cornelius. Whoops. Abergavenny player moved under the scrum there. Thrown from the ruck by Di Pickering. Looked to be Terry Richards. Jeff Gardner with the ball. Feeds it back and forwards, waits. Along the ball to Inge. Nigel Evans there, being tackled over by Gravel. Support comes here quickly for the Abergavenny back row, all there. Richards, Williams, Trumper, Avid, Rustell, they're all there. Alan Davis has the ball, but it's been taken off him by an Abergavenny player. And it's a penalty. It's a penalty against an Abergavenny player for stamping at the Ruck and Mall. Penalty to Llanelli. Just inside their own 22. There appears to be an Abergavenny player injured. Some of the other cup games has been announced. The game having finished, Newport lost to Swansea by 12-9. Pontypool beat South Glamorgan Institute 28-8. And as the final whistle goes, Llanelli defeat Abergavenny by 17-6. And what a wonderful display this has been by a truly magnificent Abergavenny team. They The town of Abergavenny should be proud of every man that took the field today. What a wonderful game. Well, Adrian, what do you think of the boys?
I think it was a marvellous performance by every one of the lads today. A real tremendous, plucky performance by the forwards. And the backs tackled well. And Abergavenny can be proud of their first 15 today.
No one can disagree with that. Wonderful Abergavenny. And Abergavenny players are now applauding their 1,000+ supporters for giving them the boost that they deserved. What can I say? An emotional moment. Tremendous. Wonderful to see such a strong ambience between players and their supporters. Well done, Abergavenny. As the players leave the ground, we take a final look at the scoreboard, which reads Llanelli 17, Abergavenny 6. The point. With me now, I have Welsh international and British Lion.
X.
And the captain of the Llanelli's team today, Ray Gravel. Well, Ray, what do you think of the Abergavenny side today?
Well, tremendous. That's the only word I can think of. We knew it would be hard, but I didn't expect it to be as hard as it was. The pack played tremendously. They pushed us back on several occasions. You've got it on film, and I think that the whole town of Abergavenny can be proud of the boys and their supporters. They were magnificent. I thought we were playing away from home because the support was tremendous. And obviously that lifts the team, but the boys played 100% effort. They tackled, you know, they wrecked them all. Damn, they won some line-up ball. They did everything, and the scores on the true reflection, really, 17-6, I thought they deserved a better score than that. And I'm shattered, I'm tired. It was as hard a game as any we've had this year. I told the boys that after the game, and they can feel very proud.
Exactly. All right, I'll let you go along. I'd like to hope you wish the team all the best in the next rounds of the Cup, and hope to see you bring the Cup back here to Stradey for the fifth time.
Thanks, Malcolm, and Abergavenny boys, thank you boys, a cracking game.
Well, after talking to Ray Gravel, I now have the captain of Abergavenny, Nigel Emmons. Well, Nigel, Ray has told me exactly what he's thought of the game out there, and he's got every praise for you aside. What are you going to say about the boys?
Well, I'm absolutely delighted. You know, it was a team performance. We came down here, we knew we weren't just coming down for the bus ride and to make the numbers up. You know, obviously, we were going to give them a game. I was a little bit worried when we first started off, because in the first minute I took Gravel out, and when I turned round they had scored in the corner. Yeah. And I thought, you know, through the back of my mind really, I thought we were going to go for a step in. We settled down then, a couple of tries which I think were a bit dubious. The referee made one or two odd decisions. When we turned round at half time, we had a little bit of a slope behind us. I thought if we played pressure and played into the corner, the forwards are sort of, you know, doing exactly what we wanted to do, disrupt any ball they had and get around them amongst them. Backs, well, we let Gravel run at us a little bit. We should have taken him out, I think, but on the whole, it was a tremendous performance. You know, I can't fault it at all. From number 15 to number 1, it was bloody great.
Exactly, yeah. Probably next to playing at the Arms Park, here must be, you know, the ground that everyone wishes to play on. What does it feel like scoring a try against Llanelli?
Really, I was a little bit lucky because Gravella was waiting for the ball, and obviously I thought that he was going to take off and sort of send it back up the field, you know, and so I was waiting. Mark Douglas lobbed a pass. One of those things, it all went so quickly, I didn't really think I was going to get the line because I could see at the corner of my eye the cover coming across, but there it was, 4 points, put him over 6, you know. I think if they hadn't scored all those points in the first half, we'd have beaten them 6-0.
Well, this is it. It was 6-0, as you say, at the end of the second half to you. Obviously, you've got the Ben Francis Cup to think about now.
That's right.
Which is more realistic for you?
Yeah, that's right. We're coming back down to basics now, you know. I mean, it's great to obviously come to Stradey Park and play, you know, it's sort of the mecca of rugby. Ben Francis, I think we've got a very good chance of winning it. We won it 1981, I believe it was.
At Abercorn,
that's right. We've got, I wouldn't say there's no easy draws, but we're away to Risker. We've beaten them 18-0 already this season. I think we've got a chance of getting through to the semi-finals, and obviously, you know, hopefully we'll go on to the final. I think the spirit is right in the club. The boys are playing really well.
Just before we go, though, Nigel, I'd like you to pay a tribute to your supporters.
Oh, well, you know, I can't fault that at all. It was absolutely tremendous, you know, for probably 1,000, 1,500 people travelling all the way from Abergavenny to support us down here. It was, well, it's out of this world, you know, it was just like a home game to us. And I'd like to thank everybody for turning up and making the day what it was. Lovely, thank you very much.
Great. This is Alan Long. Here we are, back in Abergavenny. What a fantastic game. Yes, they won the first half, but the second half was ours. Nigel over, Paul's kick. We all went wild with excitement. Must have heard us in Swansea. There was unashamed tears of joy from my eyes. Yes, and many others. The pleasure you give your supporters will never be forgotten. And I appeal to them to come along and support our local matches. I hope that this film, which I've had the pleasure in sponsoring, will be an everlasting reminder of your team spirit, tactical play, and certainly your courage. I am sure it will give inspiration to all our young players through the years ahead. You have brought honour to yourselves, to your club, and to your town. Yes, I'll always remember Stradey Park, the 22nd of January, 1983, because I was there, boys. I was there.
Cariad, fuddle on